Tonight, three VIP titans decide the fate of our rising entrepreneurs, determined to prove their greatness in 60 seconds or less.
If you want me to invest $250,000, I want to know where that money's going.
I need to know that you actually have a really good strategy.
There is one thing that all of us kind of miss. What is this?
This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business, with support from State Farm and Canon. Meet our board of investors. Mark Randolph, co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. Kim Perrell, marketing mogul and tech CEO of 100.co. Brandon Marshall, former NFL wide receiver and the founder of House of Athlete. Kicking things off in the elevator is an entrepreneur who believes his product is a revolutionary approach to train athletes.
Where I came from, I didn't have any role models who were inventors or things like that around me. I didn't have the finances and resources, but I didn't make excuses, I made adjustments. Elevator Pitch is the conduit to get me from where I was to in front of investors that can change my family's life.
Going up. Hello, Sean. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
I'm Shao Moy, and my patented esports trainer takes the everyday athlete through the process of becoming better by helping them develop proper muscle memory. When my son Elijah showed an interest in basketball, we went to the park to practice, but I didn't want him to develop bad habits when I wasn't around. And as I looked around, I saw others there with no one to help them. So I thought to myself, how can I share quality practice time and do it in a cost-efficient way, as sports camps are expensive? That's when the esports trainer, AKA Elijah Sports Trainer, was born, which pays homage to one of my greatest passions, my son. The esports trainer speaks 7 different languages, fits inside of a stylish compression sleeve, has 3 different versions in each sport to grow with the user, tracks performance in real time. The golf version is in development. I made $30,000. I'm looking in about a year, I'm looking for $250K for 10% equity in my company with a post-evaluation of $2.5 million to help grow and scale into the $8 billion sports training industry.
He hit the pitch.
He crushed it.
He crushed it.
Yeah.
He hit everything. You care about the numbers.
Yep.
He hit the numbers. You care about the business. He told you the business model.
I care about the person, and he told you about the person.
He crushed it.
Yeah.
He did.
I must say, I'm still a little confused about what the product actually is.
I don't actually know what the product is either.
I thought he did such a great job that I'm curious to hear more from me.
But do you know what the product is?
I don't.
That's what makes this so interesting, is sometimes you have to make these snap judgments. So why don't we all take a second and make that snap judgment.
Let's do it.
Let's vote.
Attention, Sean. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes! Oh my gosh. Yes! Yes. Thank you so much. I appreciate it so much.
Sean, man, when it comes to pitches, that was nothing but net. But there is one thing that all of us kind of missed.
Yeah.
What is this?
Okay, so the esports trainer, what it does, I'll give you a little bit of history. So my son, he played AAU basketball with a lot of top talent kids. And I worked a lot. 1, 2, I didn't always have the money to send him to the expensive sports camps. So I wanted to give something to other people who may not be able to afford to go to these camps. So that's what the esports trainer is. What it does is the basketball version, when you shoot a basketball, your elbow is out like this.
So your shot clock just expired. What is it?
Okay, so what this does is It helps correct and develop muscle, proper muscle memory in each sport you're playing. So for example, when you shoot a basketball, your elbow's out, it tells you to keep your elbow tucked in, to keep you in proper shooting form.
We gotta see it, show us.
Yeah.
Like,
yep.
Do
okay.
something so yep. we can see, right? Like, I still don't get it.
You want me to demonstrate or something? Or
yeah, like,
okay, come on out here, come on, come on, come on.
Come on.
All right, here we go.
Now we're gonna find out whether actually
here
we can
go.
Shoot, man.
I should've played basketball. Yeah, I didn't know that. I could've made it to the NBA, too. So tell me, while you getting everything set up, tell me about your son, Elijah, right? It seems like this is your why.
Elijah, it was just me and him pretty much for the most part. Single dad, raising my son. Some of the kids who we were playing with, they had NBA backing. And I didn't have that for him.
You getting a deal done today, how would that mean for him?
It would be awesome for him because this to me represents him. And then he's been there the whole way. So when I look at this, I kind of equate it to him. So me seeing this develop and grow, it's like me seeing him develop and grow. So I have different size sleeves as well.
And this is for basketball?
This is the basketball version.
That size is ultra ripped.
Yep. Yeah.
What's it say?
Okay. So let me show you, okay? This is perfect form.
So
that's perfect.
You see how I said, good job.
Oh.
All right, now I'm gonna shoot probably how you shoot, Mark. You ready? Yeah, that's old school right there. Here you go.
Yep.
That's terrible form.
Yep.
Okay, so okay. How are you in market?
That's
are you
awesome.
Selling in market? Tell us how you're in market. Where are you selling through right now?
So just on my website.
And how's your online sales?
Right now they're kind of up and down. I started working on for the golf version versus the basketball version, so I have my focus there.
To me, there's no perfect form,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So in basketball, you say, okay, this is perfect form, mm-hmm. but some of our greatest shooters shoot differently.
They shoot different.
And then the same thing in golf, right?
Yep.
So what's the baseline? How did you guys come up with the baseline?
So for me, that would be more at that expert level saying, my shot, Reggie Miller, for example, his shot, he likes to kick and elbow out. I wouldn't want to change his shot. So he would have that third level, that expert level. So if he deviated from his shot, then it would trigger.
Give me more. How are we finding these baselines, whether it's a golfer or a basketball mm-hmm. player?
Yep.
Because when you tell me about the novice to the expert, mm-hmm. you lose me a little bit.
Okay, so for the shooting a normal basketball, experts, I mean, that's pretty much normal. You want to shoot in the pocket. For the basketball, it has tighter specifications. Third level, whatever your form is, it records that.
Do you have data on how it's helped someone specifically?
I'm actually getting data. There's a school actually working on that project right now to get me that data.
Do you track usage over time?
I have not.
I think that would be fascinating.
Yep.
My guess is that the fall off is pretty significant. For me, engagement
yes.
is probably the most important thing for a tool like this.
Yes.
Which is not, did I buy it? Not did I use it once, but this become part of my everyday routine.
Absolutely.
And I wish you had that data because that would have made the difference for me between in or out. But
yep.
otherwise, I'm afraid I'm gonna pass.
I love actually the concept. I'm a novice in every sport, so it's perfect
yeah, yeah.
for me. Golf, basketball doesn't actually matter.
Yeah.
But from a focus standpoint, I want you to nail it and scale it. So I want to nail basketball. I'm going to see a lot of traction, and then I'm going to move to something else.
Yep.
It's concerning for me that you're actually moving already
yep.
without having the traction. So for me, I really want to see traction in one area before yep. I invest.
Thank you.
How'd you get to the $2.5 million valuation?
Just based on what I'm asking from you guys, that's my post evaluation. So pre would be like 2.2 million, but really it's starting with you guys and coming up with that investment.
Yeah, that's tough. That's
But we don't have to start there.
Yeah.
We don't have to start there because I would definitely love to work and grow.
I need to know, what is your paid strategy? Like, if you want me to invest $250,000, I want to know where that money's going. You got me as a key influencer. Yep. Some of the top athletes that train at House of Athlete. So if we push 200,000 people to your website,
right?
All right, how many people do we want to convert to be a good business?
Right.
I'm asking you.
That's what I need your help with.
You have to know those numbers. For me right now, as far as an investment, it's a pass. But if you're open to an advisor role, I think it's important for you and I to connect. And I would be honored to sit on your board and help lead the way.
That must be worth something to you to have someone like Brandon in your court.
5%, 10%, I mean.
Well, that's the wrong answer, right? And that's part of this discussion, right? Like, we gotta do good business, and a good deal is a fair deal. So a good deal here would be anywhere from 0.5% to 2.5%, depending on how much I contribute. So let's focus on the numbers first, right?
I appreciate that so much.
Let's do it.
I appreciate that.
This sounds pretty awesome. It sounds like you've got a pretty sweet deal.
And maybe one more.
Yeah, what do you guys think? I think that's pretty good. All
right. Yeah. Absolutely.
On behalf of Amazon Business, we would also love to extend $10,000 to you so you can help, you know, on your journey.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you all. I really appreciate it.
You are really welcome. Really, good luck. You're doing great work.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Elijah's gonna be proud of you. We got a lot of work to do.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. It's just amazing. I'm starting in a one-bedroom apartment with my kids working 12 hours, and it's just, if you don't give up, you can just stay the course and keep climbing and keep climbing. The sky's the limit for me now.
There's amazing men and women that's been able to pour into my life. So I think I have a responsibility to also give back and share, you know, the special people in my life.
I love that.
So I pitched the product and want to introduce you to somebody who's going to be on our board.
Elijah, what's up, man?
This is Brandon Marshall, former NFL player.
Your father did an amazing job, and he caught our attention right away. So you should be proud of your pops.
I'm extremely, extremely proud of him, and it's such an honor to meet you and talk to you today.
Anything I can do to help your pops in eSport, I'm here.
That's a blessing. That's a blessing, man. Thank you. Thank you, man.
No problem.
Our next entrepreneur hopes to break the mold with a new rebate app that puts money back into consumers' pockets.
I grew up on a lake across the street from a cornfield that was sprayed with pesticides every year. As a result, everyone got sick. So I know firsthand the importance of what you put in and on your body, and I'm not alone. 80% of consumers would buy better, especially if it was affordable.
Going up. Hello, Corinne. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Tired of spending your whole paycheck at Whole Foods? So are we. I'm Karen Frame, repeat founder and CEO of Makeena. We help you discover, find, and earn cash and rewards on better for you, better for the planet products no matter where you shop, even online. Just download the app, select products that meet either your dietary needs or lifestyle preferences, scan the barcode, and submit the receipt. In exchange, brands get valuable data about the consumers, who the consumer is, where they're shopping, and what's in their basket. We have becoming more effective and efficient with their marketing dollar. We're generating early revenue. We have 112,000 active shoppers, collected 175,000 receipts from over 40,000 points of sale. We're looking for an investor and a board member to join us as we help people lead healthier lives on a cleaner planet. Thank you.
Whew. I didn't get it.
Did she even ask for? What was the ask?
No ask.
Yes, I mean, well, she for asked a board for, member, but well, is she asked for any money?
I was confused, and that's not a good way to have someone feel after a pitch.
Yeah, I mean, early on, it seemed like she was solving a problem, and then it's like, okay, exactly, what's the product?
Well, just to give her some credit, what I really liked that she did was lay out some great traction metrics. I mean, how many people are using the app, that they have revenue? I'd like to hear that.
112,000 subscribers are users. That's a lot.
That is a lot.
Yeah,
that is a
lot. Pretty good.
Are you guys ready to vote?
I think so.
Absolutely.
Well, let's vote.
Attention, Corinne. Your pitch has been declined.
I think they missed out on a great opportunity because we're going to become a billion-dollar company, and we already have companies that are interested in buying us.
She didn't make me excited. I didn't want to hear more.
She did say some things that intrigued me. I mean, the fact that she has lots of users, that she has revenue, that there's something there that works, which is why I did want to bring her up to learn more.
The name of the show is Elevator Pitch. You gotta get your elevator pitch down. She stumbled.
Let's hope that our next entrepreneur can nail it.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Next, an entrepreneur modernizing nutrition with a new line of condiments.
Food means to me joy, happiness, community, bringing people together and being able to share with them on common grounds. I really want to take this to the next level and bring Vetchup to the world.
Going up. Hello, Lauren. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Lauren Roy, and I've been recognized by Food & Wine magazine as one of America's top emerging chefs. I'm here today to ask for $100,000 for 10% of my company. Let me introduce you to my amazing new product line called Vetchup. Vetchup is a flavorful organic veggie sauce that tantalizes the taste buds and fuels the body with a healthy alternative that comes together in one bottle. From corn cilantro to kale garlic to mushroom artichoke and more. As a chef, I know and understand the importance of nutrition and the vital role that it plays in our lives. From snacking to sandwiches on the go to your favorite gourmet dish, add Vetchup to your table. Replace those unhealthy, ordinary spreads and put flavor back to your palate. I'm Chef Lauren Roy, co-founder of Vetchup. Partner with me and Vetchup your wild side.
Did she say Vetchup?
Yeah,
Vetchup.
Yeah, Vetchup.
It is Vetchup. Vetchup your wild side. Are you ready? Yeah.
But
what
you
do
know,
you think?
You know, one thing that I think she did really, really nicely was get the ask out at the beginning.
Oh, it's first thing out, right?
She
did a great job.
Rule number one, right? Like, start with controlling the room. And she did that. Also feel like she has a niche.
Yeah.
And that's important in today's world, right? It's so crowded.
Yeah.
So I'm excited.
I would have loved to have heard a little bit more about where she was. So she kind of fell short on that, I thought.
Yeah, the traction. How much traction does she have in market already? There's a lot of questions that I still have.
So I guess my pros and cons here is I kind of did like the pitch, but I kind of didn't think I really had enough information to know for sure whether I even want to bring her up or not.
All right, well, let's vote.
Let's do it.
All right.
Attention, Lauren. Your pitch has been approved.
Yay! Hi.
Hi, Lauren.
Hello.
Welcome, everybody.
Good. Welcome to the boardroom.
Thank you.
We thought your pitch was great. The question that was missing is, how much traction do you have in market already?
So we are still in the idea stage at this point. Right now we're looking for $100,000 for 10% of our business to take it to the next level.
But have you sold one bottle yet?
Not one.
Not one.
Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I am the mother of four. I'm from an Italian family from New York, and food was always part of my world, and it always made me feel really happy. So I went to college for culinary arts and then food service management with my bachelor's degree, and started working in some amazing restaurants and fell in love with food.
Oh, let's try it, let's try it. Come on, guys, let's get it. You know, if the product doesn't taste good, we're never gonna be able to sell it.
So the first one, the green one, is a corn cilantro. That was the first one that I used and sort of had my son as a guinea pig.
How much sugar is in it?
There's no sugar in it.
Oh, amazing.
Second one is?
Is a beet lime.
All right.
Beet lime?
Beet lime, which I love to put on top of steaks. I use it as a salad dressing.
Mmm.
That's good.
The last one is actually a mushroom artichoke.
Is this the only six samples you have, or where are you at?
This is, so I don't have like a warehouse with stuff that are made. We are working with a company out of Canada. They're gonna be producing, packaging, all of that for us.
What's $100,000 gonna be spent on?
The $100,000 will be spent on actually getting the product and the packaging of it and getting it from zero to the whole production of it.
Then how are we gonna market it?
Then we are going to market it, getting it on QVC. Getting it on QVC is gonna give us a great idea about the marketplace.
But is that a guarantee?
I don't think there's any guarantees.
In your pitch, in the elevator, you talked about your brand. You said you were recognized by
Food and Wine magazine.
Food, so I would, maybe you're a celebrity chef?
I would say I've been in a lot of things as a chef. I've been on a lot of TV stuff and that kind of thing.
So why wouldn't you use your celebrity to market your product? We're looking for, you know, someone to bring the credibility. There's 1,000 different products out there. So how are you gonna, you know, separate yourself from the pack?
For me, Lauren, I love the product. I love your hustle. But I also love money. And because you haven't seen any revenue yet, it's too early for me to invest.
Okay.
Lauren, this stuff is delicious.
Thank you.
And I say that sincerely.
Thank you.
But there's something else that leaves a really bad taste in my mouth, which is I'm not sure you really understand the core thing you have to demonstrate. Because as an entrepreneur, the ideas don't count for much. The taste doesn't count for much. The big barrier is gonna be distribution. Mm-hmm. And so what I expect an entrepreneur to do is come in and say, I've proven this one thing which I know is the thing you're cynical about. And until you demonstrate that you really can get yourself on shelves, this is too rich for my taste.
Your pitch is off just a little bit, right? Like you came in strong in the elevator, but then coming out here, it's just like the differentiator, right? And owning the room. Today is not good enough just to have a nice brand and just say, okay, I'm gonna put it on the shelf and it's gonna sell out. Like you are the brand. You need to lean into that. You are a celebrity chef, whether you like it or not. Have that confidence and lead with that. I'm also out.
Okay.
Brandon, it is actually really reassuring to see that someone who is a receiver knows so much about pitching, too.
We appreciate
Thank you.
You coming out here today.
Thank you for
we
your
wish
time.
You all the best of luck. And when we get more traction, hope to see you again.
Perfect.
Thanks
Thank
so much,
you, guys.
Take
Good
care.
Luck to you.
Thank you. So the vision is still there, the passion, everything. And this was a win also for me because I got to hear some feedback that, you know, if I wasn't here, I wouldn't ordinarily hear, so this is great.
Wow, you know, it's a shame because that product was really good, but when I'm hearing a pitch,
I'm listening for four words. Here's what I've learned. I want evidence they have collided their idea with some reality.
Some in-market proof, right?
Exactly. Yeah,
she needs to get back to the drawing board because she has a great product, like you said, and figure out how to pitch. That's the key for her right now.
Make sure that your idea has a market opportunity. Get feedback before you come and pitch me. This is not from your family and friends. This is from potential customers. Will they buy your product? If you can't sell it to them, you sure can't sell it to me.
Next, an entrepreneur who hopes to elevate lingerie with sustainability at the forefront.
Going up. Hello, Charlene. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Charlene, founder of We Are Ha, the hottest sustainable brand of lingerie, swim, and sleepwear, disrupting the industry with our game-changing, eco-friendly product. Ha was born out of my over 15 years of experience leading global brands like Victoria's Secret and my passion to transform the industry with eco-friendly products that have zero impact on Mother Earth. Ha has already sold over 300,000 units via our website and our wholesale partners like Free People worldwide. We have a loyal customer following and over $4 million in net revenue doomed for this year. We are asking for $800,000 in the form of convertible notes at a $13 million pre-money cap value and a 15% discount. We have already raised $1.2 million and have some star-studded angel investors on board. We hope to hear more.
It was a good pitch.
That was a really good pitch, straight to the point, hit everything. She told us about herself. She told us about the business, the numbers. I thought she did a good job.
I certainly did hear a very, very polished, thorough, complete pitch.
Yeah, it was excellent.
Yeah, I might have to work to think of a reason why I might not want to bring her up.
Should we
take a vote?
You guys
ready to vote? Let's do it.
Attention, Charlene. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes! Hi, Charlene.
So happy to be here.
So happy that you're here. In my opinion, that was quite possibly nearly a perfect pitch.
Yes, coming from you, that is everything.
Clarify your background and experience.
I was at Victoria's Secret for over 13 years. I was executive vice president of design. I was over $2.5 billion in product categories. I also headed up Guess Global as chief design officer. But really, this is the birth of my brand, which the catalyst of bringing this brand to life was the birth of my daughters. And I really had to create product that was both sexy and responsible to the earth. We've pioneered eco-technology across every sector of the business. We have PJs that are made out of recycled plastic bottles. We have lace that's made out of recycled lace yarns, which were the first to pioneer that in the industry. And we have swim that's made of a renewably corn sugar sourced fabric.
Great for the planet.
Right.
So tell us about how it's great for the wallet.
So we're priced attainably. So we're priced right in our competition. There's brands like
Hanky Panky. For our wallet.
Oh, for your wallet. Okay, sorry. I was like on the other side of it. So great for your wallet because we have a brand with a proven concept. We have a portfolio of proven products, an architecture, a leader who's ready to scale, a team of amazing women back in Los Angeles. I mean, I think companies like Victoria's Secret and many other of the leaders in the industry are going to want to procure their eco-friendly product. We are able to start that now, and I think that will be a very sexy acquisition for major companies in the future.
How much sales will you do this year?
about 4.2 million in net revenue.
That's amazing. And how much are you raising?
We are raising a total of $2 million in the form of a convertible note. We've already raised $1.2 million to date, and I'm looking to close on the last $800,000 today.
What's the hero SKU? So what's the product that has most sales?
So lingerie is the leading category. It's 66% of our revenue is driven by lingerie, and more like 80% of our units. This actually is the highest unit driver in our business, and you should touch this. So I want you to understand that the lace is made of recycled lace. The modulus and testing on it is the best in class for recovery and color retention over time, and I swear by it because I wear it. Yeah. And our second category is actually swimwear, but I'm gonna touch on PJs, which PJs are amazing. Like I said, they're made out of recycled plastic bottles. Our prints are all digital, so they use 95% less water, and they're all hand designed by my designer and very iconic to our brand.
The 2 million?
Yes, sir.
Use of proceeds?
It is going to fund a little bit of investment in our web optimization and user interface, as well as advertising and particularly inventory to drive the sales for next year.
Well, I really like what you're doing. I would love to be in your round, not at the 800, but I would be honored to invest 200,000 in the current round.
That's amazing.
Before you begin your gloat dance, I have a comment.
Yes, sir.
This is great. This is a great company. I'm enthusiastic. I can kind of see where this goes, and it goes in a great place. You're raising $800,000. You're not going to get it all today, it sounds like. But I actually like what you're doing, so let's make this interesting. I'll also propose investing $200,000. And now you can make a decision not just on how much money you're getting, you can make a decision based on the merits.
Ah, a little competition. Whoa.
So you have Mark now in at 200,000, and you have Kim in at 200,000. Take your pick.
Okay.
I have quite a bit of experience in the apparel business, and I've seen the ins and outs of what the struggle is of building a brand which is predominantly digital, which is considering how to balance things like wholesale versus retail versus digital. So I've seen where you're going, and I think I can be of a lot of help in that regards.
I think it can be of help for sure. But given my expertise in marketing, also an investor in women's clothing, and my personal preference that I do wear this, I believe I would be a far better bet.
First of all, I wanted to say thank you for having me on the show. Thank you for giving me the time, and thank you for your offers, both of you. I'm touched. But I believe I'm gonna go ahead and go with Kim. I have done a lot of my research. Would love to have a woman of your caliber and background on my team as we build the brand of the future.
I'm thrilled to invest in you and support you.
Amazing.
All
Thank
right.
you so much, Mark. I appreciate you.
You know,
I also
good luck
I wish I didn't have to choose.
Good
Yay!
Great choice.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Bye-bye now.
Oh my God, to have Kim and Mark both make an offer, and I was like, oh no, I didn't want to upset anyone by having to choose, but I was very honored.
She was brilliant, truly a perfect pitch.
Yeah, that was almost perfect, but there was one thing that wasn't perfect about it.
That I won.
And you know what that is, Kim.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Our final entrepreneur hopes her tea tumbler will brew up a deal with our elite investors.
Hello, Melissa. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hello, lassies and lads. My name is Melissa Wiggins, and I am the co-creator of Bruetta. Bruetta is revolutionizing how 160 million Americans consume tea each and every day. Until now, Bruetta is the way to brew better. The secret is in our patent-approved lids. We are here asking for $500,000 for 10% in our company. We are so excited to be at the point ready to launch this direct to the consumer. Already, we have done an incredible job across break rooms in America, and we are ready to brew and make the world a better place with your help, with the right investor. Our strategy is ready to go. We're ready to push the button, ready for the green button. We are so excited, ready to go. The secret is in the patent, remember? The lid. Bruetta, let's brew a better world.
Is it a tea company?
No, it's a lid company.
It's a lid company.
It's yes,
a lid
that's what
for
it
tea?
Is.
Yeah, it sounds like it's a lid for tea. Hmm. But here's a case where someone doesn't yet have a business, they don't have metrics, and those are fine, but then you had better be explicitly clear about the one thing you do have, which is your product and your idea. And I'm afraid even that didn't come through for me.
Well, I'm not sure. I mean, I think she struggled, you know, at the beginning of her pitch, probably the first 50 seconds, and that last 10 seconds was strong.
Yeah.
The last 10 seconds, she said, don't forget, this is the secret.
I mean, it almost sounded, as a matter of fact, like she was checking what floor she was on and saying, well, I still got a little time left. Let me throw some more stuff in the basket.
Do you at least want to try the tea?
Let's vote on it.
Let's vote.
Attention, Melissa. Your pitch has been approved.
Yay! Woohoo! Woohoo! Yay! I'm so excited! Thank you!
Well, Melissa, welcome to the boardroom.
Thank you so much for having me in the boardroom.
Where are you from first?
Scotland.
Can we start there?
Scotland, yes, which actually popularized tea. So there you go, in the 1600s.
Well, at least I'm getting some good facts out of it. And listen, I'll be very transparent from the beginning that we were not unanimous.
Boo.
And that I'm afraid I was the dissenting vote. But let me explain why. I kind of wanted you to nail it with here's what this product is and why it's so special. And I didn't get any of that. So you haven't lost me yet. So tell me, what is this thing?
We actually have this in over 100 break rooms across the United States currently. So we have contracts with...
What's it? We have it in 100 break rooms. That's the piece I'm missing. What is this thing?
So we have a patent approved in order for you to have loose leaf tea basically on the go. So this is what we have in our break rooms currently. So we have 8 different types of tea, but the real kicker is in the cup, which has a special IT that is going to allow you to drink loose leaf tea on the go.
So it's a container? The IP is the container, it's the lid?
Yes, it's in the tumbler lid.
So it's been in 100 break rooms. What was the point of that?
So we wanted to prove the concept, right? That this was something that people would want to continue to use. And we actually have 100% of all of the companies that have it are restocking, regoing. So we already have a consumer base who is going to be our first hit before that's who we're going to be trying to sell this to in the first place.
But are they buying the tea or are they buying the cup?
So we have deals with Airmark, Frontline, Canteen, and they're putting it in their break room. So not yet, the tumbler is what we're about to launch, and that's what I'm asking the investment money for.
Are we selling the tea or are we selling the cup right now? What are you selling?
Or both.
Both.
Yes.
Today,
yes.
In those break rooms, you're selling both the tea and the cup.
Yes, that's what's available right now. So it's essentially this, and then you're putting the loose leaf tea in, and you're having it to go at work, right? But now I want to be able to take it direct to the consumer so we can buy online, and that's what we're about to launch, our direct to consumer, and that's what the investment is for.
I would love to try it.
And I would love to let you try it. Let's do it. Here's some I made earlier.
All right. Make sure you spend more time with this guy, right? Because He's the one we have to convince.
Is there a patent on the top?
Yes. Yeah, oh. on the lid, yeah.
But not this lid and not this top. That lid.
No, this is
this
the,
too.
This
yeah. filter
lid?
Yeah. Lid is your lid.
Yes.
So what is your strategy and your plan when it comes to distribution?
So in terms of the break room space, I feel pretty confident in our partners and what we're doing there. Really, I'm here today because of the direct to consumer and sort of learning how do I take this to the consumer at home. Our hashtag is Brew Better, and we're trying to get that into the homes of all of Americans that are consuming tea. And so right now I'm looking for help on how do I do that? How do I take this direct to the consumer? I already have the product ready to go. I have the logistics, the manufacturing side, all of that down. I'm ready to just push the button and get this in the homes.
What are you going to do with this raise?
Really just push it out in order to get more people to have this tumbler. That is what I'm trying to do.
But don't they need the loose leaf tea with the tumbler?
Well, you can't, I mean, online, the way we've packaged it will be like, there'll be a sample of the tea, right? You could buy like this as a starter pack with the different samples of tea, definitely. But I really feel like the winner is in the cup.
In terms of reoccurring revenue from an online perspective, the best idea would be to continue to sell the tea over and over for the same tumbler, right?
Of course.
I love your passion, and I love tea. For me, though, in this opportunity, it's just so early for the amount of capital you want. I need to know that you actually have a really good D2C strategy. I'd like to see a reoccurring strategy because that's why you have tea. I'm out.
I love the idea of being able to do loose leaf tea. I get it.
Okay.
And I kind of like the idea of doing a razor and blades model where maybe you get the cups into the break room and you sell more and more tea. But I have no idea if that's what you're thinking. I'm completely confused. And so based on what I've heard, well, I've heard enough.
What I want to see, one is your passion, you know, and two, I want to see that you know your stuff. When you talk about e-com, I need to know that you know paid. And hopefully you take today and learn from it and be better the next time. But I'll have to pass this time around.
Well, sorry, Melissa. You made a great try at it, but it looks like you're 0 for 3 today.
Thank you.
Best of luck with it.
Thank you.
Keep going.
I'm feeling overwhelmed, honored to be here, disappointed to not get a deal, but also just loved all the feedback, which is invaluable.
I want to try something.
All right.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Mark Randolph. Do you know that 150 million households in this country drink tea? But the existing way is you have to steep your loose leaf tea in a small pot and then pour it in some souvenir travel cup to go where it gets cold and picks up bad flavors. I've invented the very first portable to-go cup for tea, which allows you to brew your loose leaf tea in the cup. We have patent-pending technology. We've been test marketing this for the last year and a half in break rooms. And in 100% of the cases, they have all said they would borrow more.
How much do you want, Mark?
Boom.
How much do you want, Mark?
I tell you what, I got a special for you today. $6 million for 2% of the company.
Oh, Mark, no way. That was a phenomenal pitch.
But I'm
$6 million for 2%?
I'm willing to negotiate, Brandon. But anyway, that's the kind of stuff I want to see.
Right, right.
Yeah,
I want you to pick out what is your differentiator and just nail it.
Yes.
Though two entrepreneurs elevated to greatness, three were sent back down to the basement with nothing to show. Whether it's a new invention or a new way of living life, anyone could be 60 seconds away from rising to greatness or fall from glory. Tune in next week as Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch continues.
Come on. I didn't see it. I didn't feel it.
I think you've lost, Kim.
Yeah, 40 million. I choked.
And to apply for the next season, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Investors personally styled by celebrity stylist Kim Bolafay.